I'm probably one of the most competitive people that will play. When I get into that battle on the field, or when I know a batsman's trying to get the better of me, that brings out a competitive side of me.
Brilliantly bowled.
I think that's when I bowl at my best.
This is a fantastic over from young Pat Brown.
For me, it's mainly more about slower balls and deception. I want the batsman to be guessing where the next ball is going to be rather than knowing it's going to be somewhere and setting up for it. I think my bowling style is probably a mix of being coached different sorts of things and different deliveries and having a natural ability to kind of deliver them. You obviously have to find a way when you're just coming into the game to be a bit different or find your little niche.
Knuckleball, got him, absolutely superb.
I learned the knuckleball off a coach last year and sort of managed to have a natural ability to be able to bowl it to a decent level. So then that was one I thought, this is something I can really work with and develop.
Yet another knuckleball, it wobbles, it dives.
So it was just about knowing that was what I wanted to work on and keep going with it, and even if it takes 2 years, it'll get to a level where it is good enough to obviously do well on finals day with that as your main weapon as such. Last season I played a bit of the 50 over stuff towards the back end of the competition, and I found myself in the team through someone else's injury, which isn't nice for them, but obviously as a sportsman it's kind of what you have to think, this is my chance and I'm not going to let them get their spot back.
This has gone straight up in the air, taken, he's got another one, there's one catch, what a game he's having.
I was trusted with the last over to try and defend, I think it was 10, might have been 11, to get us to a Lords final, which where we'd never been before.
Shoveled away into the leg side. Oh, it's been parried over the boundary for six. Length, he's got it up and over. This could be it, it's all over. Worcestershire put up one of the gamest defences of 306 that you could imagine, but in the end it just was not enough.
And I didn't manage to do that, so that was quite disappointing. Feeling that disappointment is something that really helped me to get to the level I was in 2020 last year and learn from that situation and know when that situation came again, what I would do differently, what I would do the same and how I could think in that situation.
Should be out, yeah, good catch. This is a fantastic 19th over from young Pat Brown.
My focus was completely on the runs and knowing that even if I got 3 wickets, that didn't mean the game was over. It was more about the runs than anything. It's them fine lines in bowling at the death that's quite important. So for me, on that day especially, it was all about reducing the runs, and luckily or skillfully, I managed to do that and to make sure we got to the final.
Gone! Massive moment in the game. Brilliantly bowled. It's not gone very far and it's taken.
4 wickets he finishes with now, Pat Brown.
I have to kind of pinch myself and think, look, I'm 20 years old and I've done what not a lot of people will have done in their career.
She's picked out long off, simple catch.
And that will do nicely. The Worcester players sprint out to the middle. Worcestershire Rapids T20 Blast champions.
In 5 years' time, I'd hopefully see myself still playing cricket for a career and hopefully being successful in all formats as well, knowing that 9 times out of 10, when you walk out on the pitch, you can have a good game. So I think just looking for that consistency, being a more all-round bowler and having the success in all formats rather than just one or two as it's been so far.